walk through the line. We're going.
You always want me to go through the lines. Do you guys ever notice that I'm the only one here and I always have to go through the line when I can just walk around like a normal person? But no, they want me to just go through. Hey guys, it's Adriana and we are in Volcano Bay. We have been to all of Universal's park. So we've been to Islands of Adventure, we've been to Universal Studios, and now we are finally in their water park. There is 4 dining locations, 2 full bars. We're gonna make our way all the way around the volcano and we're gonna try it all. There's gonna be pizza, chicken, barbecue, lava cake. So out of all of the Universal parks, this is the most affordable. And I think it's quite honestly the best, because look at the view you get. And of course it's Florida, so it's hot all the time. And this is a year-round water park. So you can come right now. It's August by the time this episode comes out. It'll be September. This park is still open. And it still feels just like this. An 80 degree day, it's hot, the water is cool. This is Iconic Eats. Woo! I'm coming, Volcano! So we're getting our first item of the day. It is a fried chicken platter with a tropical twist. I'm so hungry. Let's go. Hi, can I get the coconut crusted fried chicken platter? A dark meat, please.
Dark meat, sure.
Yes. Oh, I'm so ready.
Oh, it smells so good.
We are at the Kahola Reef Restaurant and Social Club. We have the coconut crusted fried chicken. It also has like a cucumber, mango slaw with it, and of course french fries. Do I go in for the drum first or for the thigh? I'm going to try the thigh. And also because it's like coconut crusted chicken, I need to try the crust first. Do I taste the coconut? Not really. Is it really good fried chicken? Absolutely. Oh, she is hot. She is a hot piece of chicken. It's just good. I did not think that I would get really good fried chicken at a water park, especially like a tiki Polynesian themed water park, but this is pretty delicious. And the crust is like super crispy. I love chicken skin. It is my favorite. It's good.
I'm taking some breakfast fries.
Breakfast fries!
It's not even 9 a.m.
We are still here at the Social Club, and we have the Hawaiian ribs platter. So ribs, the same slaw that we had before, and more french fries. I do not know why I am so very excited about ribs today. I feel like, there was no ribs in Minion Land. I feel like we get ribs almost every theme park, or at least we've had a lot of theme park ribs. So I have a lot to compare them to. Mm.
Look at that.
That is so smoky. Like, I know ribs are smoky in general, but like, this has like a considerable amount of smoke to it. You see how I'm pulling that meat off the bone? That's how I want it, tender. I don't want to have to work too hard for my ribs. I'm at a theme park. Life is easy. Why am I chewing too hard? This is so perfectly tender. Just pull it right off.
Mm-hmm. A mermaid princess eating her ribs.
Mermaids know how to get down in the kitchen. Like, I feel like they eat a good amount. You know, they swim all day. They have an athlete's body. They have to fuel. Okay, so we have the mango barbecue pulled pork sandwich. Still are at Kahola Social Club. I feel like for this to be a social club, I need to have a drink. We're going to get that next. I'm going to focus on the task at hand, which is eating this pulled pork sandwich. Okay, so it has a slaw on top, mangoes, and then a full pineapple. There's pulled pork covered in barbecue sauce, and it is just dripping out of the bun. Just be, you know what?
Slow-mo?
Yeah, get it slow-mo. pointed out that I while I did eat food, I didn't even put a dent in this sandwich.
Lipstick?
Yeah, just a little lipstick. You know, it ate me. I didn't eat it. So I'm gonna say of everything we've had at this restaurant, this is the most bang for your buck. It is $12.99. Like I said before, I took a bite. You can't even tell. I think you can share this with at least another person. It is just chock full of pulled pork. Like one growing man cannot eat this. I've had all my food. I got my fry for the road. Let's go. I know I said we were getting a drink, but I got distracted. I saw somebody walk by with a rainbow ice cream and I needed to get one too. So we're gonna go over here and figure out what that was. Treat is called a waturi fusion. So it is banana, strawberry, orange, and blue raspberry. Ah! Okay, let's try. Banana! Why don't they have this at Mickey's Land? I guess you can only get it here at Volcano Bay. But this tastes like banana. Okay, I'm trying to get the strawberry section. This is trippy. So each part, okay, me and my boyfriend had this conversation a while ago. People say that Skittles taste like different flavors. To me, Skittles taste like Skittles. There's no different, there's no grape, there's no strawberry, there's no lime. But this is like, this, I thought it was gonna be like that, where it's like, y'all say it's different flavors, but it's really not. No, legitimately, this is banana, this is strawberry, this is orange, this is blue raspberry. It is so good. They're making magic in the back. Get one. Right next to like the tiki guys, and they keep talking to kids, telling them that
hey you.
I don't know what he's talking about. Okay, we have a paraguaya. This is a Puerto Rican shaved ice. You get it in pineapple, raspberry, and tamarind. I got tamarind. Why did I get tamarind? Because I thought it was the most interesting sounding flavor. I've never had tamarind before. I don't even know what this gonna taste like. That just tasted like just ice. Hold on, I'm trying to drink the juice. Ooh! It's sweet, but like, similar to like a florally sweet or like a bubblegum kind of sweet. It doesn't have like a distinct flavor other than, I guess, that is what tamarind is. I don't know. Either way, I really like the flavor. And it is very hot. The sun is so high in the sky. And this is just cooling me off. You know what would make this tamarind even better? If they put something in it. I'm gonna go get a drink instead. We are at the Dragon Bar. This is my favorite spot in all of Volcano Bay. I have been here 5 times before. The duration of all of the times I have been here has been spent in this bar. But I am a sip, drink, eat type of girl. And this is the best bar in the park. They have a plethora of different tiki drinks, and this is the tiki punch. It is 3 different types of rum. 2 of them are berry flavored. It is very, very forward. And then cranberry juice, you know, just a splash. This will get you in trouble. It tastes like Kool-Aid, but like the best tropical, like fruit punch Kool-Aid you ever had. And you know it's got just straight alcohol in it. And so you can drink it very quickly and then just, you know, float away.
Oh my God. We still got more drinks.
And now you have to go back up to get the beer. You know what?
So hard. Okay, I have been walking. It is so hard to walk in sand. It's just a struggle. You just gotta work too hard, you know? I feel like this is what's gonna deter me from drinking so much, is that I gotta do this all day to get back to the bar. I have a volcano blossom. This beer is exclusive to Volcano Bay. It is made from a local Orlando brewery, and you can only get it here. In a previous episode, I've always said that I'm not a beer connoisseur because I'm not a beer connoisseur. I got tired of saying, I don't like beer. Me pretending that I am a beer connoisseur, which you all know I am not. Y'all already know how I feel about beer. I wish I was more sophisticated to tell you what this tastes like. I'm not gonna play like I'm a beer connoisseur. I'm not a beer girl. I'm not a beer person. But I did take a little class to teach me more about beer. I don't know if I absorbed it all, but I'm gonna try to put those skills to use because I'm tired of telling y'all that I don't like beer.
I'm not a beer girl.
I gotta evolve eventually.
I'm not a beer person.
Oh, wait, okay. The words will still fail me, but I do like this one. There's definitely a tropical flavor there. It's not grapefruit. No. I feel like it's passion fruit. It's passion fruit or guava or something. Guava or something that you feel like you would have on the islands of Polynesia. It is your turn to try it, my beer lady. Tell me what you think about the wheat we brew here in the land of Orlando.
Can I be real?
Yeah. You don't like? Get out. Get out. I can't even, like, I was going to let you have this and I wanted my drink back, but whatever. I guess I'm just double fisting until we get to our next location.
Fine. Sorry.
My feet are like in between being sandy and wet at the same time. It's a weird texture. But there's a lazy river. Oh, look at the people.
What in the rainforest is this?
This is the kids' play place. It is a magical land full of rocks and waterfalls, and it's right up my alley. But just so you know, if you do not have a kid, they don't really like you playing over there. So, as somebody who does not like big rides, I went over there and I was like, oh my God, this is great. And I was playing in the water and I was like, the slide looks so fun. I get to the top of the slide and she goes, no ma'am, this is for children only. And my heart was broken. I know you like a jerk anything, jerk chicken, jerk shrimp.
Thank you.
Like a little spicy. Thank you.
You're welcome, enjoy.
It's so pretty. It's
so pretty. Okay, let's do it.
This is a jerk shrimp mac and cheese. Oh my gosh, look at it. It is pan seared shrimp with jerk seasoning and then shells with a white cheddar cheese sauce. Back in the day, I don't know if it was Applebee's, I don't know if it was Chili's, one of those chain restaurant places had like a Cajun pasta that had everybody in a chokehold. This is that pasta. And it's so good. The cheddar cheese sauce is creamy. It's not, like, you know how like if you let cheddar cheese sauce sit too long, it kind of congeals and it's not as creamy or as moist as it used to be. Like, it keeps its consistency. The jerk shrimp is spicy. Like, it has kick to it. Absolutely delicious. The breadcrumbs on top is just, like, the perfect little adding of texture. And I do want to note how big this bowl is. Like, look how big my hand. I don't have big hands. Look how big it is. Like, it's like my whole hand. It covers more.
For Chelsea.
And yes! This is a large side. It can feed a family of four with a chicken.
Or just a one Chelsea.
Chelsea reviews are always two words or more. I love. So good. Chelsea review time.
Tastes good.
It's really good.
That's good.
Oh my god.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no.
Cheers, eat it.
More funky.
Funky. This is all day drinking beer.
That needs to be a button that you press.
This is all day drinking beer. I'm ready for my next item. You thought we was gonna come to a Polynesian tiki themed water park without getting Hawaiian pizza? Oh my gosh. All right, confession time. I was one of those people that used to say, why would you put pineapples on pizza? But since then I have had it and I know that it is delicious. So this has pineapples, jalapeno, ham, cheese, and marinara. Oh, it's sweet, it's salty. The sweetness of the pineapple brings out the sweetness of the marinara. I'm not getting too much spice from the jalapeno, I lied, here it comes. Sweet, spicy, salty, crunchy, cheesy. It's known that Universal has better pizza than most theme parks. And they're showing it, they're showing off.
I'm sorry, where did this fan come from?
I got a mini fan. It's so hot outside. Anybody who's like, oh my god, Adriana, your makeup stays perfect all day. You look so good. What did you do? I have a tiny fan. The memories are coming, rushing back. All right, so I promise you guys a story time. I have been to Volcano Bay, obviously, before. The one time I decided to get on a ride or an attraction, they have a lazy river and they have an extreme river. And so I walked over to the extreme river and I'm like, can't be too crazy. They have on life jackets. I can't drown if I have on a life jacket. Side note, I can't swim. So I get in the extreme river and it's good. I'm bouncing along. I'm like, oh, this is kind of enjoyable. This is really fun. At the end, water rushes out and a big wave comes up. And the wave takes me away. I should have knew that something was about to happen because the children were all waiting. They're like, here it comes. And the wave comes and it just takes me away. And I'm just drowning. Literally drowning. The lifeguard has to jump in the water and pull me out. And here I am, a 30-year-old woman who knows I can't swim, in the water, just ashamed of myself. Because why would I put myself in danger? Was it slightly traumatic? Yes, but it does not make me not love this theme park. So, this is very thrilling. Just beware. And Julie and Chelsea got on it yesterday, and they loved it.
We did it three times.
And the important part is don't get in this if you can't swim. It's still happy. I thought I was brave. I was trying to be brave. Kanuku Bar. This is our second bar. I promised you two bars. Now this one is in the back of the park. Have I been to this one as much? No, but they both have the same menu. And I have had the wide watermelon quite often. Raspberry, vodka, watermelon. It is garnished with a watermelon. And then a cute flower on top. I don't think this is an edible flower, but I do love that flowers season drinks. As I talked about on our Virgin Voyages episode. So let's have a sip. Hopefully it cools me off because of the sun. She's coming back out. Why, watermelon? Why are you so delicious? I've said this before. I'm like, the watermelon swam by. This is not, the watermelon didn't swim by. She sat, she marinated, she hung out, she infused the drink. This is it's a big punch of watermelon. It tastes like a Jolly Rancher. It is definitely sweet, so if you are not a person who enjoys a sweet drink, this one might not be for you. But if you're anything like me, I just, you know, a little sugar never hurt nobody. Okay, so we've tried rum, we've tried vodka, but my favorite is whiskey. So the next drink is gonna have whiskey in it. So one of the fun things about doing this job is I get to choose what I want to drink. And Julia said, Adriana, you can pick another drink. And of course I picked whiskey. This is the Waturi Comfort, SoCo Southern Comfort, Amaretto, Orange Juice. I wanna smell it, can I smell? You can't really smell, you smell just mostly orange juice. You know, like sometimes whiskey is really strong, you can smell it. I think that's why I like whiskey, because it's like, it gives you a punch. And you always know that your alcohol is in it. I get more amaretto than anything, and I like it. So this is like your typical, like Mai Tai or just tiki drink in general. Like they generally have a creamy element and a tropical element. So the amaretto is giving you your creamy element that has like that nice warm feeling to it, and then you have your tropical, so your orange juice got a little cherry in there. I always love the cherry at the end. It's just been swimming around in the juice. Oh, get your little zip. There's the river of death. No, it's not the river. I'm gonna stop calling it the river of death.
It's a scary river.
It's the fearless river. I felt brave. I've had a liquid courage and I still don't feel brave enough to try it again. Maybe if you hold my hand. Hold my hand. I have to walk so far to the next location. It's like a mile away. We're here.
We made it.
Right next to the boat bar, there is a taco stand. So I know I said this was a taco stand, I'm not ordering tacos. So I'm gonna start with the poke though. Can I get the poke bowl?
Yes.
I'm gonna get the loaded nachos too. Double up. One for me, one for you. We gonna share both. We are at the Feasting Frog. It looks like a frog, the whole stand. There's big lanterns that look like his eyes. He's like the big bulging eyes. And this is the poke bowl. It's tuna with a pineapple salsa and a soy honey vinaigrette with plantain chips. Universal's poke never disappoints. I think we have had two other pokes. And so this one is no different. Just as good, but it's a smaller portion. I feel like it's a great option because it's fresh. You want something fresh and cool in the hot sun. You don't want anything like super filling. Although, we did have a pulled pork sandwich earlier, and it was that is filling, and it was good. But if you're looking for a lighter option, poke is always great. Oh, you got a big bite. Big bite for the girls.
I feel fancy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness. That is really refreshing.
Mm-hmm. I really love the use of pineapple in it. Like, there's always a lot of fresh fruit in a lot of the food we've tried today. And I think they get the gist of how you want to feel when you're outside and hot. You need something fruity, juicy, a lot of water content, keep you hydrated. Don't pass out.
Crazy. Let's go grab some nachos.
Oh, yes. I ordered nachos too. Let's go get those. These are the loaded nachos. Chili, cheese, sour cream, jalapeno. Real simple. On top of tortilla chips. You can't go wrong. Classic water park food. With the amount of the ratio of cheese to sour cream, for me, it's perfect. I like just as much sour cream as I do cheese.
We are saucy.
I love a saucy chip. Oh my gosh. And then I love when it's like chili instead of just ground meat. I feel like you get more flavor. You get a little bit of beans. You get a little bit of salsa. You get a little bit of ground beef. This feels familiar. So I definitely recommend this. If you have like food anxiety or about trying new things at a theme park, or you just want something familiar that feels like home, get some nachos. This is the back of the volcano. There are two slides, one aqua coaster inside of the volcano. And then this is a really cool drop. It's one of the only water coasters in Orlando, so it's like propelled by water. It's really interesting. So there's no track, it's just water. And then like maybe some little slippy slotties to help move you along.
Scary looking.
It is very scary. I have never been on it. But people tell me that it's amazing. Hello. Hello. I'm getting a edamame quinoa burger. I feel like a lot of times we have like meat substitute burgers. And I enjoy a burger that's just made out of plants, like just made out of like vegetables, patted together, seasoned with special seasonings. It's good. You don't have to give me a meat substitute. This is the quinoa edamame burger. It has shiitake mushrooms on top with a chipotle mayo. I do not think it is completely vegan, but I'm pretty sure they can make any dietary restrictions you need happen. Oh, let's try it. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about the shiitake mushrooms. It's a more expensive mushroom, so. It's giving falafel. It tastes very much like a falafel burger. Fun fact, I don't know if many people know this, but I used to be vegan / vegetarian. For a short time, I was like vegan, and then I was vegetarian, and then I went to pescatarian. Now I do the show and I eat everything. But that's why it's like really important for me to show like vegan and vegetarian options, because like I used to be the kid who came to the theme park and like, it's like, what can I eat? Whole vegetables, patted up, made into its own unique burger. The quinoa makes it crunchy. It makes you feel like you're really eating something hearty and meaty. And then the shiitake on top. Shiitake is always delicious. It's always a good addition. It makes you feel like you're eating more than just like lettuce and tomatoes on a bun, you know? This is the mahi sandwich platter. It's funny, everything we've eaten today has been called a platter, and Universal does have a habit of calling most things platter. So I'm like, what qualifies a platter? So when I think of platter, I'm like, you know, like 5, 6, 7, 8 things. All right. So on this sandwich, we have a thick piece of mahi. It has a pineapple salsa and then a remoulade sauce. And the bread is like, I just know this bread is buttery. Like, you know how like you pick up a bread and it's pillowy soft? And like you feel the texture and you like, I know they put a lot of butter in this bread. Ooh, she's dripping.
Wow. My goodness.
Do you want to try it again?
Yeah, I'll try again. I want to try, let me get some of the meat.
We're falling apart.
I want you to see. This is a big piece of mahi. Like, oh, it is a thick boy. Of course, you would love like it on a sandwich with the bread and like the salsa and all of that. But honestly, just give me the piece of fish. Very fill. Cut that.
What just happened?
Filling, meaty, well seasoned. I just probably wouldn't want it on a sandwich. The bread is buttery, like I told you, but it's a lot. Maybe I've eaten a lot today, but it's a big sandwich. We are still at Bamboo, but I needed something sweet, a little dessert, a little pick-me-up. And this is only $4. This is a chocolate pineapple upside down cake. It is layers of cake, toasted coconut, pineapple, with a chocolate-covered cherry on top. I just talked about how I love cherries. And like, all I can think about is just that I want to eat this cherry. Let me get my bite, though. I wish I could. You absolutely cannot cut it with a fork. But look at the chocolate-covered cherry. This is the best money I've spent all day.
That's your favorite thing?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's high praise.
This is the part of the day where we get to do something very exclusive, very VIP. Okay, so there are a couple things that you can do in Volcano Bay that are VIP. They have premium seating over by the beach area where you get like a fancier chair and then like a little canopy. But they also have cabanas. And so we're gonna go to our top floor cabana. We're gonna get a beautiful view of the at Volcano. And then you can order anything in the park straight to your cabana. So the rest of the food, we're gonna order up there.
Our baby's on it. Look at her.
It's for us. Me, you, Julia. Let's go. I'm ready for my cabana. Welcome to my private cabana. Let me take you on a tour. So you have chairs everywhere. And then in here, a refrigerator for you. You have your own server that comes to your cabana and gets you anything you want. They have exclusive menus. So these are drinks that we had at the bar. All of the food that you can have at any of the restaurants, but you don't have to actually go anywhere. So there are exclusive items on the menu as well. And so we're gonna order one of those, which is the chicken sliders. You can't order that anywhere else in here. And then I promise you guys, lava cake at the beginning. And so we gotta have lava cake while we look at the volcano.
How are you?
Hi, how are you?
All right, so we have chicken sliders.
Oh my gosh. Looks beautiful. Thank you so much. We have island coconut crusted chicken sliders. It's just a very fat chicken tender with that sriracha mayo on it, a little bit of like remoulade or like sauce at the bottom, and more pineapple. You know what one thing they're gonna do at Volcano Bay? They're gonna give you pineapple or they're gonna give you some mango. Huh? And a crunchy piece of chicken. Let's taste it. Like I said before, it is exclusive to the cabana menu. So this is just a fat chicken tender. The bread is a Hawaiian roll, and then it has a slaw underneath. It's very fresh. I didn't think, when I started today, we did start with the chicken. And I think I said that I didn't think that the chicken was gonna be one of my favorite things that we've had here so far, but they really know how to do a chicken tender and fried chicken, and it's just perfect. I've been promising the chocolate lava cake all day, and we finally have it. It is the perfect finale to our day. Ooh, it's so gooey. When they created a chocolate lava cake, they did something, because like I've never had a chocolate lava cake that has ever been bad. This one is like sitting in like a pool of like some sort of like raspberry or strawberry syrup that is like giving it this extra brightness that you would like want, just an added touch to the chocolate. And it is just like ooey and gooey on the inside. I love it. Can all lava be chocolate? This has been such a fun day, and I am no longer in Orlando, Florida. I am transported to some island that is Volcano Bay. And I am gonna enjoy the rest of my day here in my private cabana. But I have tried all the food for you guys. I let you know what was good, so you know what to do when you come here. But with that, I will see you guys on another day at another park for another adventure. Bye! No, for real, bye Chelsea, bye!